Davis, ever since I've been on this set, I've heard nothing but discussion of Eve. May I have your opinion of her?
The golden girl, the cover girl, the girl next door, the girl on the moon. Time's been very good to Eve. Life goes where she goes. She's been profiled, covered, revealed, reported. What she wears and where and when, whom she knows, and where she was and when and where she's going. Eve has insatiable ambition and talent. An improbable person with a contempt for humanity, an inability to love or be loved.
But how can such a woman fool so many?
How does any Eve do it? She's a girl of so many interests.
Pretty rare quality these days.
A girl of so many rare qualities.
So she seems.
So you've pointed out so often. So many qualities so often. Her loyalty, efficiency, devotion, warmth, and affection, and so young. So young and so fair. Eve, my understudy.
Didn't you know?
Of course I knew.
Just slipped your mind.
Find out.
Only thing. What I go after, I want to go after. I don't want it to come after me.
Don't get up. And please stop acting as if I were the Queen Mother. I'm sorry I didn't.
Outside of a beehive, Margot, your behavior would hardly be considered either queenly or motherly.
You're in a beehive, pal, didn't you know? We're all busy little bees, full of stings, making honey day and night. Aren't we, honey?
Very touching, very Academy of Dramatic Arts.
That bitter cynicism of yours is something you've acquired since you left Radcliffe.
That cynicism you refer to, I acquired the day I discovered I was different from little boys.
Come on, get up, I'll buy you a drink.
I'll admit I may have seen better days, but I'm still not to be had for the price of a cocktail. Like a salted peanut.
What's so funny?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Everything. Everything's so funny.
Everything. What's coming off here? Get back into those things, young lady, while we take a better look at the inmates of this hilarious house. Here's Connie, a landlord who makes paying your rent a pleasure. This is Jim, who has his hands full with a blonde in his arms in the basement and a cutie on his mind upstairs. That's Charlie. He has more love affairs than he can get away with. And this is Bobby, an old army buddy who just got back to her base of operations. Wow.
You know, all the time we were overseas, Jim talked of nothing but you. You must have found that pretty dull.
Oh, no. Jim can make anything interesting.
I shall never forget my first conquest. I was 2.5 weeks old. We had a French nurse.
My name is Gray, Federal Bureau of Investigation.
Oh, well, come in.
I'd like to ask you just a few questions about one of your tenants, Mr. Charles K. Patterson.
Is something wrong?
I'm sorry. I'm not at liberty to discuss the reason for our investigation.
Oh, but Mr. Gray, this is very important. Is he dangerous?
What's the matter?
The house is loaded with cops.
The police arrive in the nick of time. The plumbing goes out most of the time. And the walls rock with fun and laughter all the time in the screen's most heartwarming housewarming in years.
The sanctity of divorce, do you?
It's all right for people who've never been married.
Well, life is no fun if you play it safe. For us, it will be gay and mad and romantic.
And illegitimate.
Yes, it's the hilarious story of a lady who was only slightly married. And two guys who were only slightly gentlemen. See Claudette Colbert, MacDonald Carey, and Zachary Scott knock the eternal triangle slightly out of shape. See blonde Marilyn Monroe, Miss Cheesecake herself, and beautiful Barbara Bates fight it out to the last dimple. Who cares if it's legal, as long as it's fun?
I'm just glad I divorced you before I found out what a heel you really were.
You're the most exciting, the most desirable woman I've ever known.
Well, and you're an expert on women. I suppose you think he wouldn't marry me.
Not even if you drugged him.
So you don't think I could do it?
I'll lay 20 to 1 against.
You're on.
I thought you didn't approve of gambling.
This'll be a pleasure.